thankful you have made these great DIY Valentine's mailboxes, which are so, so cute. And I know they were inspired by Hallmark's Think, Make, Share blog as well, right?
Absolutely. If you have not checked out the Think, Make, Share blog, you have to do it today. The ideas for the blog come straight from the creative studios at Hallmark. Look at how adorable this is.
There's so many different types too. Look at this.
So many. You can go to create or celebrate, and all the ideas for all of the different holidays and entertaining ideas. Like, you can see all the ideas here for Valentine's Day, and there's different ideas that you can do with your kids as well. And what I love, Cameron, is that they're all step-by-step instructions.
Great.
They're easy to follow, and as you can see, yes, you go through here, you will feel like a pro because it will look just like that. So you can see, as you said, today we're doing the DIY Valentine box from Think, Make, Share. And I am excited to do these for two of my Valentines, Grant and JJ, my babies. They're just getting so big.
I know they are right there. And they're eating a little treat, and they're in heaven. And
this is just my life.
That's a great photo. That's your life in a photo. And we're going to make your life right here for these guys as well. Now, here's the thing. Like, recently, we made another DIY together. When I say we, I mostly mean Maria. But there we are with the Valentine's Care Backs. And it sort of functions in a similar way, but this would be great to have as like a tabletop to go along with that.
Absolutely.
No?
So I was looking for inspiration, like, and that's why the Think, Make, Share blog came to me.
Because, gotcha.
Sometimes the teachers would like the kids to have a box that they can do, and they can have it on their desk. So sometimes there's different requirements that the school has, which is great. So I'm using a shoebox. So that is
easy
why
enough.
This is the perfect DIY.
Okay, good.
For
Let's get started on this guy right here, because it looks pretty cool.
So you have some options. So like I said, a shoebox is the way to go. I've actually found these online. So if you don't have one just laying around, but you can see, Cameron, right by you, this big guy here, you can use like a big shoebox as well. Any size will
work. I got tons of those.
I'm going to assign
too many.
You something. I believe you. So here's some scissors. So this is what I did. I took the sides off, and if you can cut this back off for me, that's
okay,
great.
You got it.
So I wanted to make these really beautiful. So I have this gorgeous Hallmark wrapping paper. And as you can see here, one of my favorite things about Hallmark wrapping paper is the grid that it provides.
Me too.
On the back. Oh, it's
I mean,
the best thing
as like
ever.
A structural engineer,
yes,
like, that makes
exactly.
me so happy.
So what I do for this, and it makes it so you can even things out. So, oh, I have four or five on the side, whatever the case may be. So that, well, your first step is to basically wrap this, but you're not wrapping it like a regular present because you don't want to cover the top. So you can see here, what I did, I went outside and did a spray adhesive.
Okay.
You can use tape as well. So for instance, if you want your kids to do it. And then I started covering, but I'm gonna swap to one that's covered so I can give you a great tip. In order to make this flat here, you can see, I did this on yours already, Cameron.
Okay.
I took some tape and actually folded it down like this so that it goes underneath. So
oh,
you can
nice.
See here.
That is a little bit like a regular present.
It
That's
is like
the only
a present.
Part that kind of, yeah.
Yeah.
What
so then,
idea.
Like I said, the spray adhesive, or you can use tape, and that's what we have here. So now we're going to finish the inside.
Now we're right here. Now we finished the inside. You want to take care of that detail as well.
We're repurposing the top.
Oh.
So put the top in here, because that creates some structure along the bottom.
Oh, a little bit of strength, a little
exactly.
bit of support. Okay,
and I
good.
Have these pre-cut for you, Cam. So there's two of these cut. One of them is going to go this way along the side. So what this does, and I have some tape here. You can use tape. You can use a hot glue gun.
Sure.
So what you do is you actually put it in here because what this does is it actually covers up the sides so that it looks really pretty just all together. This is totally optional.
Gotcha.
But it's kind of fun, and it makes it look really just beautiful and cohesive.
Oh, and this one goes the other way.
You see?
Oh, man.
And then you can just use some tape. I'm going to use some tape here. But like I said, you can absolutely use hot glue. If you have your child working on this, you could just use some school glue.
Easy
like
peasy.
That. So you can see it's
pretty. Fantastic. You barely don't even need the tape. I didn't even tape it. It looks fantastic already.
Exactly. Okay,
okay,
so
great. So then what's the next step after that? The little...
So we want to make it look like a
mailbox. The top.
Exactly. So here's the thing.
Okay.
Same thing. You can see it doesn't look like I have my grid on this one because I actually did... I measured out how basically from here to here, if that makes sense. So
yeah.
I measured this, and then I actually did spray adhesive, and this is poster board.
I see.
Added it to poster board because I wanted it to be my top. So I'm gonna actually place mine in here.
All right.
And I made it long enough so that it could actually go all the way down, at least somewhat close to the bottom, because that gives it really good structure.
It does.
And you can have like a higher top or a lower top. add some hot glue. You can do tape if you want, Cam. Some hot glue, and then you can add your adorable details to this.
I gotta say also, like, you could actually make this. It's like one of those tapeless wrapping
yeah,
jobs.
Exactly.
You can actually make it without hot glue and without tape. Mine is completely functioning on its own, and I haven't added anything like that. So that's
exactly.
well done.
And these
great
details
prep.
Here are provided on Think Make Share.
So okay.
They actually have these cute little details, like the little side right here that you want to
aww.
Do this. And then I'm a sucker for a pom-pom, so you can add some pom-poms, some pom-pom trim, then you just go ahead.
Add this guy right here. How about that?
Yeah, exactly. And like you said, if you do just want to use tape or some school glue, you can absolutely do that. And I just did a little bit of the...
All the decorations. And I'm going to get to it in a second here, but I'll tell everybody at home for more inspiration, go to thinkmakeshareblog.com. And for full instructions, you know where, hallmarkchannel.com. And fromscratchwithmaria.com. You've got options, right?
So many options to be
when we go.